All right, so that example that we just talked about is something that I drew up on the screen, I decided I would actually turn that into a real example and ran it in burlap with the implementation of MLIRL that's there. And this is the result. It's actually kind of neat. So here's the trajectory and the MDP that we ran in. And here's how MLIRL decided to actually assign rewards to the different colors. So you can see that the cell that's green is assigned very high positive reward. So it is drawing the agent over to that. That is a positive place to be. And you can see that the blue squares are actually fairly negative. The ones that correspond to these blue puddles are given a not insignificant negative reward, so they are actually avoided on purpose. One of the things that's interesting is, as we talked about, there's no sort of evidence in this trajectory that red is good or bad, and in fact, it ends up getting pretty much the same reward as the background, basically zero. One thing that's a little bit more interesting is that it actually concluded that this orange strip is somewhat aversive. It gave it a slightly stronger negative reward to try to get it to avoid it. And I guess that was because the demonstrated path didn't have the agent spending multiple steps there, and it could have.
Yeah.
But it didn't.
Right.
So maybe it was a bad place.
Right. So there's lots of ways that it could have gone all the way over to the orange and gone straight down.
Yep.
But since it didn't, it maybe tried to pick a path that minimized orange.
Right. And so it just kind of went with that and gave it a slightly negative reward. If we gave it a bunch more examples and we could see negative, well, whether the orange really was consistently a good thing or a bad thing, it would get fixed with more training data. But it's pretty neat how much it can pull out of actually one single example.
That's actually kind of cool. And I do like that it gets slightly negative. It doesn't believe that you're trying to avoid orange, just that maybe you are, because if you weren't trying to avoid orange, I guess if I thought about all the paths that could get me from where I started to where I ended up, there's a lot of them that involve touching orange more than once. And since you didn't pick that one, maybe you're trying to avoid touching orange more than once. And since they're all the same thing, that would be evidence that it's something to avoid, although it's only very slight evidence. So that turns it in slightly negative. That's kind of cool. That's kind of amazing.
Yeah, I think so too. I mean, and one of the things that I really like about this is the notion that it's actually learning not just from the positive example of where it went, but in a sense from all the different paths that it didn't take.
Right.
Right. And so the fact that it didn't hit blue, it used that as data. So it actually is combining this notion of, you're planning in the full MDP with, well, we get to see one trajectory through that. So what is that telling us about other parts of the MDP?
So I guess the short version of this is you can communicate a lot even by communicating a little. And an even shorter version of that is less is more.
Well, no, I wouldn't say that at all.
But you just did.
I did, but then I read it and I realized that that's not what you meant, or that's not what I wanted you to mean. So yes, that you can communicate a lot with a little. Less is enough, maybe.
I like that. That's like 8 is enough, and 8 is less than 9, so less is enough. I like that.
And that pretty much sums up the 3 C's that I wanted to talk about.